You may be wondering, do I need to get screened for colorectal cancer? Or is it just the person who has colorectal cancer running in his family? Or is it just the person who has had GI issues bothering him all his life? Or maybe it's the person who has a genetic mutation? Watch this video for a breakdown on the expert recommendations on who needs to get screened for colorectal cancer, why and at what time to start to have the best chance of lowering your risk of developing colorectal cancer. My name is Vera. I'm a passionate cancer prevention educator, a former marketer of anti-cancer medicines, and a mother of three. On this channel, Cancer Worry Free, you will find science-based updates without the science language in a bite-sized format. You will learn about best practices in early cancer screening, advances in cancer prevention, and health hacks to help you lower cancer risk for you and your loved ones. Colorectal cancer is the third most common cancer worldwide. On the positive side, colorectal cancer is one of the most easily preventable cancer types. The early and preventable colorectal cancer, however, has barely any symptoms, which is why it is so important to get screened at the right time. Yet, with many effective screening options available at our fingertips, still to this day, one in three eligible Americans does not get screened. Are you one of them? What stands in your way of getting screened? Please write down in the comment section below. If understanding the reasons, the risk factors, and the expert recommendations stand in your way of getting screened, this video is going to set the record straight. If understanding the different screening test options stands in your way of getting screened, then watch my other video to help you pick the right screening test for you. Subscribe to this channel to get weekly updates that will help you become the best advocate you can be for your timely cancer screenings. Who needs to get screened for colorectal cancer? You. Everybody with a colon and a rectum needs to get screened. Low, average or high risk, it doesn't matter, because one never knows which out of many factors might trigger the development of colorectal cancer. So better safe than sorry. Everybody needs to get screened. Why does everybody need to get screened for colorectal cancer? Here are the three reasons. The first reason is that colorectal cancer is on the rise. It is a marker of economic transition. As more countries improve their economic status, the more they adopt Western diets, habits, and sedentary lifestyle that predisposes their population to colorectal cancer. So, with the good news of economic advancement, come the not so good news of an increase in colorectal cancer diagnoses. The second reason is that colorectal cancer is affecting new and larger age groups than before. In the past, colorectal cancer was most common in people over the age of 50 years old. Now, about 12% of all colorectal cancer cases happen in people between the ages of 20 and 49 years old. The last reason why everybody needs to get screened for colorectal cancer is that the majority of colorectal cancer cases are sporadic. No genetic mutation, no family history. Most people find colorectal cancer sneaking up on them, and they can prevent that with timely screenings. We talked about who and why needs to get screened for colorectal cancer. Now let's talk about the timing. When do you need to get your first screening for colorectal cancer? The answer is, it depends on your cancer risk. In general, the higher your cancer risk, the younger the age at which you may need to start screening for colorectal cancer. There are three general categories where one could fall into. 70% of colorectal cancer cases have low to average risk. They're people who have no family history or known genetic predisposition. It is called sporadic colorectal cancer. 25% of colorectal cancer cases have average and elevated risk. They are people who already have colorectal cancer and some other predisposing diseases running in their family, but there are no well-established link to a particular genetic mutation. 5% of colorectal cancer cases have high risk of developing colorectal cancer. They are people who have well-researched genetic mutations associated with the development of colorectal cancer. Here is a breakdown of each of these categories to help you determine your particular level of cancer risk. You have a low to average risk of developing colorectal cancer if you have no family history or genetic mutations associated with it. Additional risk factors that raise your chance to develop colorectal cancer include smoking, obesity, alcohol consumption, poor diet, which includes red and processed meat, sedentary lifestyle. You have moderate to high risk of developing colorectal cancer if colorectal cancer already runs in your family and there are no recognizable genetic factors. The closer the relative and the more relatives with polyps or colorectal cancer diagnosis you have, the higher your chance to develop colorectal cancer yourself. Inflammatory bowel disease made of Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, as well as insulin-dependent type 2 diabetes, increase your chance of developing colorectal cancer. Lastly, you have a high risk of developing colorectal cancer if you already have been diagnosed with any of these genetic conditions. Familial adenomatous polyposis, called FAP, Lynch syndrome, also known as hereditary non-polyposis colorectal cancer syndrome, MUTYH-associated adenomatous polyposis, or known in short as MAP, Peutz-Jeghers syndrome, juvenile polyposis, and Ashkenazi Jewish heritage. Depending on which group you fall into, your age of initial screening for colorectal cancer would vary. Let's look at this chart with the recommended age for the first cancer screening to find out at what age you need to get your first screening done. Here I have summarized the recommendations of various professional societies for each specific predisposing condition. You can see that the high-risk genetic conditions call for an initial screening, some starting before the age of 10 and no later than 20. The only exception in this group are the Ashkenazi Jews, for whom the first screening is recommended in their 30s. In the average risk conditions, inflammatory bowel disease requires an initial screening about 7 years from the start of the IBD symptoms, which for most people would be in their mid-20s. People with a family history of colorectal cancer, as a rule of thumb, need to do their first screening 10 years before the age at which their relative was first diagnosed with colorectal cancer. Patients with type 2 diabetes need to start screening at the age of 40. Lastly, the rest of the people with low to average risk need to get their first screening done at 45 years old. 45 years is the age we all have to take away from this video. Most people diagnosed with colorectal cancer are low to average risk, so when they start screening their colon and rectum at the age of 45, they get the best chance to prevent colorectal cancer. So let's summarize who needs to get screened for colorectal cancer. Everybody. Why? Because colorectal cancer is affecting more people at younger ages and takes most of them by surprise. When do you need to get screened? The recommended age of first screening would vary from person to person, depending on their particular risk factors and predisposing conditions. I hope that the information in this video gives you the knowledge and the confidence to advocate for timely colorectal cancer screenings with your doctor, your insurance company, your family and loved ones. If you found this video useful, please click the like button, comment below and share the link with your friends. Consider subscribing to this channel to stay up to date on advances in cancer prevention and timely screenings. I will see you in the next video. Until then, worry less and live more.